Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show how to make a simple herb garden using the Kratky method. Basically, it's a non-circulating hydroponic method, so you don't need any air stones or anything. This is what I'm going to use to build this. It's about a 4.5 gallon, and I like this because the lid is raised so I can get more head space so I can actually use more solution. But to show this on a micro scale, this is a lemon balm in a bottle with nutrient solution. And this is the sponge material. I started the seeds directly in this, filled the solution up so that it came up to about here. And then the rest wicked up via capillary action. So the seeds sprouted in this, and this is, it's been growing. So I'm going to transfer. I've got a few of these. Some catnip. There's a little rosemary. Got some white sage. This is regular sage. All these are Kratky systems. And I've got a couple basils that are in narrow gardens. Well, they could have been started the same way. So I'm going to do 8 plants. And I'm going to use these air garden baskets, just like I did with these. And I found that a 1.5 inch hole saw drills a perfect size hole for one of these baskets. And but don't limit yourself if you don't have these. If you have 2 inch net pots, 3 inch net pots, you can make any of these work with the grow sponges. You can use the air garden grow sponges. I like these biodome sponges from Park Seed. They're basically the same thing, but they're way cheaper. And they're shaped a little differently, but they fit in these just fine. But you could also fit some in one of these and just fill around some clay pebbles or cocoa chunks or something. You cut one down, stick it in a 2 inch net pot. Or you could even use rock wool if you didn't have these, or if you had rapid rooter plugs, you could cut those. So just follow more of the principles of what I'm doing. If you don't have the exact same things, you can improvise using what you have already, or what you can most easily acquire. I like these just because they're convenient and they work really well. And you can buy these separately without having to have an air garden. First, I'm going to first do is just take an old one, and I'm just going to draw out where I'm going to place my holes. So I'm going to do that with a Sharpie. So I'm going to put 3 on the outside and then 2 on the inside. That should give me 8. So just kind of eyeballing to get as close as I can. Try to space them out as much as you can so they have room when they grow. And I'm probably not keep them in this system forever. It's kind of a something to get through till plant out time, and I'll probably move them to something bigger later. If you watched my lettuce Kratky video, it's pretty much the same principles. I'm just growing herbs. So that's kind of what I've got. So I'm going to go ahead and drill my holes. And for the hydroponic solution I want to mention, I've got some pre-mix. It's master blend mixed with magnesium sulfate and calcium nitrate. And it's kind of a weaker solution than I would normally use. Any kind of water-soluble solution that you may already have or could get cheaper or easier than this would work fine too. Just maybe mix it a little less than full strength. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and drill these holes. I'll start in a forward direction until the centerpiece goes through, and then I'll switch it to reverse, and it just makes it easier to cut a cleaner hole in plastic. So anyway, I'll go ahead and drill these out. And I'll show you on the first one just kind of what I'm talking about. So this is in a forward direction. That's through, and then I'll just switch it to reverse. see a hole and just see how that fits in there just right. So I'm gonna go ahead and just drill the rest of these out. Also, if you have a used Kratky method, there's a lot of information online. So it starts out with seeds or even a transplant. You're waking up via capillary action from the solution that's touching the sponge. And the roots will grow down. These haven't really, there's a few coming up. But the roots will start to grow down and draw up the solution and use it up. The roots that are hanging above the solution in that moist air layer between the lid and the top of the nutrient solution, it will start doing all the air exchange. So that would be how the plant primarily gets its oxygen through the roots, and the roots that are in the solution do all the feeding. So ideally you would have a system with enough solution that would carry the plant to maturity to harvest. But if you're using smaller systems, you have to add some back in. And there's different ways to do that, but if you're just pouring it back in, just make sure that you don't add too much or you'll drown those air roots. So if you see that your plant starts to droop after you added some, you probably feel too much, just pour some of it back out. So just be aware of that. So anyway, let me get this cleaned up and I'll get the this into position where I'm going to put it, and we'll fill the solution and add the plants in. So I'll be right back. I'm going to keep it here on this wire rack under two T8 shop lights. I'm gonna go ahead and pour in my nutrient solution. Went ahead, took tape and labeled where I'm gonna put everything. And I wanna go ahead and snap this on so I can check the depth with an empty net basket. So. Okay, so that's about right. So I'm going to go ahead and add the ones I've got here. Catnip. White sage. Rosemary. Lemon balm. Regular sage. Cinnamon basil. And I need to get some net baskets for these other two, right? But these I had in my air garden sprout. This is my mugwort. Actually, it fell out and fell on top of itself. So hopefully this didn't get damaged, but I think it'll be all right. There goes there. And this is my Italian basil. Kind of stick these in the back because I know they'll grow faster. And if I need to rearrange, if it's early, you know, sooner I can do that later. But so anyway, that's that. And so today is March 10th. I'll get updates on this for a few weeks before I post the video to show how it does. One thing with light proofing, I probably should have done something with the lid. Maybe use a plastic spray paint and paint it black underneath. But with just being shop lights, I'm not sure that it'll actually penetrate this to be a concern for or it's growing algae, but definitely we need to do something that was under a stronger light or going outside. I will follow up soon with progress updates. Okay, here's the herb garden 19 days later. This is, so it started on the 10th, and this system started on the 10th, it's the 29th now. The ones in the back are growing a lot faster. We've got a catnip here. Really nice. This is the cinnamon basil and the Italian basil, a little bit taller. This is my sage. It's just the regular sage. It was flopping over a little bit, so I made a little, it's kind of got it in the little hole of the clothespin. I could probably adjust it a little more, but it's keeping it more upright than what it was. The ones in the foreground aren't going quite as fast, but they actually have done a lot in the last week or so. This is the lemon balm, mugwort. It's actually done quite a bit in the last week. And the rosemary is the smallest, but it has actually progressed quite a bit as well. So I think it's starting to take off, starting to get the roots going and all. Take a quick peek at these roots. Yeah, it's looking really good. Quite a bit of solution left in there as well. But yeah, those look great. So that's real easy to start, maintain, and really once you get it going, you just have to top and prune occasionally, harvest, whatever you want. And some consideration should be given to the types of plants you grow together as far as the growth rates. See these, I'm having to raise lights to accommodate these taller ones. That means less light for these smaller ones, so that's something to consider. Anyway, hope you like that. Thank you for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe.